went into that locker room and just crushed the guys, undressed them. Just the way we handled that press down the stretch was really, really disappointing. That's a joke. I just, first and foremost, like Eric Henderson is a dear friend. I got just an absolute tremendous amount of respect for him. I'll be the first to tell you I am glad I'll never have to see Alex Arians or Matt Dentlinger on the basketball court again. You can just see the poise, the emotional stability that those two have. And when I say all these things about the respect I have for Eric and this program and those two young men, it tells you the magnitude of this win for us. I mean, this is a terrific win in a hostile environment. I thought our guys, besides a stretch in the first half, were men. And very pleased in an atmosphere that was just terrific to play in. Certainly pleased to get the result. And again, like we talked about last night, we need to be able to flush this and move on, because we certainly know the challenge that is tomorrow night.
Go ahead with questions for the players. Go ahead, Tim.
Grant, Tim Hill, Reaches Zone Podcast. You always hear about shooters getting in the zone. Tonight, you were all over the glass, oftentimes equaling their entire rebounding total. What was it where how you were seeing that ball come off the rim tonight? What was it?
I mean, our guards doing a great job getting into their guards, forcing them into tough shots. And I was just in the right place at the right time on the other end of it. So, I mean, those freshmen, Damari, Jakari, he's not a freshman, but Jakari getting to those guards and forcing them into those long twos or long threes.
Grant, it seems like you've really relished playing spoiler in this environment the past few nights with just some of your reactions at breaks and stuff. Can you just talk about how much you've enjoyed playing in this environment?
Yeah, it's a great environment. I mean, both nights was pretty much all South Dakota fans, which we love. But, I mean, we're going to go out there tomorrow, hopefully with the same thing that it's been for the past two nights, and we're going to go out and do what we got to do.
Mike McPeely from the Forum in Fargo. Boden, just a comment on Grant's night tonight. I mean, 22 rebounds is a tournament record, just all over the place, just doing everything.
I mean, it's just crazy. I mean, I think he had two less rebounds than the whole South Dakota team. I mean, he's just a different beast. I don't know what to say.
Ross, I'm five for Boden. You guys got off to a tremendous start, and they punched back. The young team could have folded. Why didn't you guys?
You know, I think the freshmen just stepped up. Like, Damari Wheeler-Thomas just did a great job on defense and just controlling our offense. And, you know, if you didn't know who he was, you wouldn't think he's a freshman. He did a great job of just controlling the pace and everything. So I just give all the respect in the world to him. He did a great job.
I was going to ask you both about Damari. He's a kid that needed somebody else to step up maybe and make some shots and control the offense. He was that guy tonight. He had 15 points or something. He was in the jumper.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, he was in the shots tonight, but probably what you don't see was just how much on stat sheets, how much work he was putting on defense guarding Mayo. He just did a great job. I know he was cramping the whole time. He just battled through it, and he's just a dog. And we love to have him on the team. He's a really good player.
Grant Diamonds, OWDAY, 3 years in college and 3 years playing in the Summer League Championship game. Can you describe that of getting to this? It's not easy to do this 3 years in a row now.
Yeah, we've been here before, but this time it's going to be different. We got to come out like we have these past two games. We got to give it our all.
Last question, right here.
Jeff Colbath, Forum. Grant, how important was it to keep the crowd to minimum levels here?
Yeah, I mean, in the first half, they went on that run. The crowd got into it, and it was tough for us to fight back against that. But we did it, and I mean, we just had to stay into them defensively and get stops, and that translated over to our offense.
Grant Boden, thank you very much. You can head back to locker room. Questions for Coach Matt.
Matt Zimmer, Sioux Falls Live. Dave, how important was it to kind of take momentum back from them before half? You went on their run, they went on their run, they got the crowd into it, but it felt like you guys took the momentum into halftime.
Yeah, we exchanged some unpleasantries during that one of those medias, and you know, Boden addressed it a little bit. Like, that's where we've grown so much. You know, we would have success, and somebody would punch back, and we could just never rally. And basketball is a game of momentums, especially in an atmosphere like this. And so You talk about maybe sometimes you don't see the growth in your own kids and your own teammates. That's visual growth right there for the maturity.
Ross, Dave, you mentioned it was a terrific atmosphere, obviously very pro-South Dakota State, very pro-South Dakota last night. Others have maybe just expressed that they don't love that the tournament is so close to those two places. Why is it terrific when you have, you know, that many thousand Jackrabbit fans howling at?
Well, I think first and foremost, everything in our program is control what you can control, eliminate excuses. This is what it is, right? The tournament's here. Now, I'll tell you this. I'd rather play in front of 10,000 people than nobody, whether that's 10,000 people that are against you, right? I mean, this is college basketball. And there's a spirit and atmosphere behind it. And, you know, our league, the city, the Sioux Falls Sports Authority, I've said it countless times, they just do a tremendous job of putting on a first-class event. And, yeah, a big part of that is the two South Dakota schools and the way they draw. But again, like I said, I'd rather that than no atmosphere.
Dave, kind of more off of that question, with last night's crowd, tonight's crowd, I asked you last night, you know, what do you talk about with these guys staying level to, you know, keep at it, bring it again tomorrow night?
Well, I just think sometimes, you know, there's the Grants and Bodens of the world that got major chips on their shoulder and they relish in this environment. I think sometimes your youth, they don't realize what's, you know, going on. They're just playing basketball. And I did a really poor job. You know, these two get a lot of credit and it's well deserved. But DeMarcus Wheeler Thomas was absolutely tremendous tonight. What he did on both ends of the floor, and he's begging me to take him out. We just couldn't take him out. We had to call a timeout to rest him there. And, you know, that's a freshman. And you saw some of our struggles early. We knew what we had in him. And so it was big to get, like, you know, that third piece clicking tonight.
Just to sum up Grant Nelson's play the last several weeks, he's just been fantastic the last 3 or 4 games.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if there is really a way. I think the biggest thing that I give that young man credit for, and I mean, listen, it's well documented, all the narrative and the buzz about the NBA and all these things, and yet all he's continued to do is prioritize NDSU Bison basketball and winning. And, you know, I mean, he's talented when he makes shots like he did tonight. It's just pretty much impossible to guard. He's gotten to the free throw line. He's gotten paid at the free throw line. He was dynamic on the glass tonight. Just obviously glad we got him on our team.
Coach, can you describe the minutes from Andrew Morgan tonight specifically?
Yeah.
His free throw line performance?
Yeah, I mean, the big fella was really good. I mean, we expected that percentage, right? What did he shoot from the line? 6 for 7? Yeah. You know, I remember as a staff when Andrew committed and how excited we were because we knew the talent, the potential. And sometimes you look at that monster with that mullet and you think he's 35 years old. He's a 19-year-old kid. And he was, last season was half of a season for him because of his, you know, his spleen injury. So a lot of ways he's another freshman out there experiencing some things. And to find that consistency and the focus, I think that's what you see this time of year. Is guys are able to take it up a notch, those talented guys like Javis did last night, like Andrew did today.
Last question right here.
Dave, we talked in November about just all you want is a chip and a chair to get to the NCAA tournament. Again, describe where this group was in November to now being on the doorstep.
Yeah, really proud of them, Dom. And we got to stop talking about all those things and get these guys some rest, some fluids. And we got a tremendous challenge. I mean, Nicole Roberts is 20-0 against Summer League competition this year, the same place we were in last year. And we didn't get it done last year. That always leaves a poor taste in your mouth. And so, you know, we've got another opportunity, thankfully. I know we've earned that opportunity, which I'm really proud of. We'll see what happens.